Bohr-Rutherford diagrams, example number 2, potassium, element number 19. First things first, when you're drawing Bohr-Rutherford diagrams, how many protons and neutrons do you have? Well, 19 protons, because that's the atomic number of the element. How many neutrons? Answer is the atomic weight, which in this case is about 39, minus the number of protons. In this case, it turns out we have 20 neutrons. So you write 20N, and that's our nucleus. Now we need 19 electrons. So, in the first shell, up to 2. In the second shell, you're allowed to have up to 8. So give me a second to put these in. 7, 8. And now I have 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 electrons total. I need 19. So draw a third shell. I can put up to 8 in this one as well. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And I still only have 18 electrons total. I need one more. So I draw a fourth shell, and I put a single electron in there. You can fit 2 in the first, 8 in the second, 8 in the third, and up to, well, I guess the examples that you get, you're only going to have to put up to 2 in here, but this one can fit much more than that. If the atomic number of the element you're doing is more than 20, it's trickier and harder. Check out my other video for that. Good luck.